Hey guys, Michael is back today with sort of a tutorial on how to shoot a brush with pigment colors, makeup colors, a high-speed shot in the studio. So here's the image I'm talking about, and some of you probably might already have an idea on how to take a picture like this, and I guess most of you don't have a clue. So, to give you an idea on how to shoot something like that, that's why we're in the studio, and that's what this video is about. So, let's do it. Okay, the most important thing for this kind of shot is, guess, it's lighting. Lighting is the most important thing in photography, I think not especially only for this shot, but yeah, for everything in photography, light is the most important thing. And for this image, I used flash lighting, of course, in the studio. And the key question is, where does the light come from? And in this image, I decided to create a black background. And for this reason, it's really important that you don't have any light hitting the background. So you don't even need to have a black background. This could be a white background as well. As long as there's no light hitting the background, it will be black in your image. It's like magic. So what you need to do is you need to have a light that's really focusing on your spot, on the area where things are happening. Let me show you how to do that. I use this reflector, but that's only half of the secret, because what you need is this. This is a utility which helps you to focus your light. So it's a honeycomb grid, and I don't know if you can see that, but you can see through if it's straight, and if you turn it to the side, you cannot see through. So if you combine these two, then your light will focus in just one direction and give you this beautiful spot of light, and there will be shadow just right next to it. So if you don't have a studio strobe, you can also use these grids on speed lights. That's no problem. Let me show you what the small grids for speed lights look like. Now that's a grid for a small speed light, works the same, and you can use this for smaller light sources. So that's what you need if you want to have a black background. The next important thing is you want to freeze the motion. So in order to do that, you need a very short flash duration. So most speed lights give you very short flash duration, so that should be no problem. But if you have a cheap studio light, it will give you a pretty long flash exposure, and you will need to turn down the power of your studio strobe to give you a really short flash duration in order to freeze the motion that we're going to create. Okay, so you have the lighting from above, you have the grid, you have a beautiful spot of light, and you need to adjust the settings of your camera in order to work. So what you can do is you decide what aperture you want to choose. For this image, you don't have a lot of depth, so you can go like the sweet spot of your lens should be around 8 f8, so you choose that aperture. If you have enough depth of field for your kind of shot, that's the best thing to do. So with aperture 8, choose a low ISO because you don't want any noise or grain in your shot. And a really important thing is to choose a shutter speed that's not shorter than your sync speed. So you will go like around 1/200th or 1/160th of a second. That's fine. So in one hand, you're having the brush, you're holding it, and you dip the brush into your color pigments. And you move the brush like this to create this awesome cloud of color pigments. And the other hand, you push your shutter release. It's as simple as that. You will need a lot of tries to get the right moment. You could also fiddle around with some trigger stuff to help you doing that, but I think you should do it by hand because it's more fun and it's really easy in this case to get a good exposure and a good timing. You don't need any special external flash or camera triggers. Trust me, I shot this one just the way I told you with my hands. So you take some pictures, maybe like 10, 20, 30, 50, whatever. Keep on trying, keep mixing different colors, and that's it. So you get an image that looks pretty decent already. And yeah, that's only the halfway because you will need, or at least in my case, I edit a little bit of post-production to remove my hand from the shot, you know? That's pretty easy. You take another picture of your brush, you hold it on the other end, try to get the same angle, but it doesn't have to be. And that's your material for Photoshop. And that's where we're going to now. So let me take you to the computer and show you the way this image was edited. And you will be surprised on how little editing there was involved. So let's go to the computer and see what this is all about. Let's go. All right, so we are at the computer right now. As I told you, I have already opened the image to show you what it is that we shot. And yeah, let's have a look at the adjustment layers over there. And let's start just the way this image came out of camera. It was like that. Yeah, as you can see, it's not a lot different than the final image. There's a little contrast. There's some cleaning up over there. And of course, as I told you, I removed my hand from the shot. So that's the way it came out of camera without any post-processing. So I guess you're interested in some technical stuff, like everybody is. So let's have a look at the dimensions of this image. This image is 9,500 by 6,500. I guess it is a little cropped. 9,500 times 6,500. So this is still roughly 61, 62 megapixels. Originally, it was shot on a digital back and it had 80 megapixels. So let's zoom in. That's the nice thing about the high resolution. And you can see very nice details in this shot. And I've printed it in a really big format for a gallery and it looked so nice. It was so awesome. So, post-production, yeah. Let's have a look at this, at these layers one by one. So we had a little adjustment curve down there, which I have used to turn down the blacks even more. Yeah, I think it was not necessary, but it's something that I like to do to keep it really black. This layer over there is to remove the hand. You see, it doesn't look nice if I do that, but it's just a little, let me show you what it is, just a little black painting. Doesn't even look nice if I have just this layer, just some black in this area where my hand used to be. And the next layer is just the grip of the brush, which has a little mask. The mask looks like this, and that's the way how this grip area is being replaced. So we have a little
dodge and burn going on in there, which doesn't do a lot. Does it do anything? Let's see. Yeah, we have a little dodge and burn, you see, just to get a little highlight on the grip over there. Let's turn it off again. You can see this area is not that nice, and I gave it a little shine and a little shine in this area as well. And the rest are just adjustment layers. So we have some saturation going on here. We have some selective color correction. If I turn this off, you can see the colors are changing. And it's just a matter of taste. It doesn't really matter if you keep it like this or you do it like this. I just decided to go in there. Well, not everywhere actually. Yeah, the blues, the reds, magenta, nothing, white, nothing. Yeah, just adjusting the colors a little bit to match my taste. Then we have a black and white adjustment layer, which helps me to increase contrast. You see the blend mode is soft light, and it adds contrast, which helps to blend the grip in the background and helps to get contrast in the cloud. And then we have a little curve which pulls up the midtones and highlights. So if I turn this one off, it looks a little more faded. Yeah, it's just like a little correction to the exposure. I think you could have done that in your RAW converter or directly in camera, or you turn up the flash a little bit, because the image like this is just a little too dark. Not much, little bit like this, much better. So if you compare the before, which is this one, and the after, which is the final image here, you see there's not a lot of difference in post-production. So it almost came out the way it was supposed to, directly out of camera. And that's the way you want to do it. Keep doing great photography. Don't waste too much time retouching your images. And yeah, you have time left to go to the next image. That's it.
All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you learned something. I really hope you can take this shot yourself. Maybe you can find some variation of an interesting idea that you can do in the same way. If you like the video, hit subscribe, hit like, of course. See you next time, have a nice day, and happy shooting!